To a today weather alert with millions bracing for a fresh rain event threatening to wash out the weekend. Let's bring in meteorologist Dean Naramore from the BOM headquarters. Dean, I feel like here we go again. Which areas are going to be in the firing line?
Yeah, absolutely. It's just one lower week at the moment. We're going to see a low develop once again over WA today and tomorrow. It's going to move through South Australia on Friday and then into southeastern parts of the country on Saturday and Sunday. At this stage, the heaviest falls look to be through northern Victoria, western Victoria as well, and possibly into southern New South Wales. And the other unfortunate news is it looks like some of that rain is also going to spill over the Lachlan River. So it means those already flood-weary communities could be seeing more rain again, particularly Saturday night into Sunday.
Gee whiz, so what does that then look like over the weekend for especially that Forbes area?
Yeah, so again, we're looking at probably possibly anywhere from 15 to 25 millimetres, hopefully on the lower end of that. A bit more hit and miss this time, which is good news, as the focus at this stage looks to be further south, particularly along the Murray, where we could see bigger falls of more so 30 to 50 millimetres and even higher again through our elevated areas on the weekend.
You're saying much of that rain's going to hit western Victoria. What about Melbourne? Is it in the firing line?
Yeah, it looks like the heaviest falls, it's going to miss Melbourne. It's really through northern and eastern parts of Victoria and possibly into the south coast of New South Wales as well. Areas that are already saturated. So once again, we've got numerous warnings out for those locations and we could see renewed rises on many rivers again as we move across into the weekend and early next week.
Has it been a bit strange, the weather we've been seeing over the past couple of weeks?
It hasn't been strange, it's just been very wet, and I think coming off the back of three very, very dry years and then obviously those devastating fires, and then ever since then the pattern flipped around February or March in 2020, and it's been pretty wet across particularly those dry areas of eastern and southeastern Australia, and it's been really wet and cold the last few weeks as well through much of the country, and that pattern looks set to continue as we move into the early part of summer.
Yeah, it hasn't felt much like summer these past couple of days, has it?
No.
We've all had to
unless
find
you're in Darwin,
Wayne,
that was 38 the other day, which was a record.
I did see that and kind of wished I was up there. Anyway, Dean, always good to talk to you, my friend. Thank
What's
you.
What's going on behind
Same.
You, Ellie?
See you. Cheers.
What do you mean behind me? So, whoa. But my hair's not moving.
Tell you what, it's blowing like a gale down here. A Megan gale.
Know what I'm saying? It's very dramatic, is all I'm saying.
That was fun.
First time I've been in a cyclone for a while.
It is for a while, isn't it?
Oh, how was that on the seat? Is that what you're saying?
Huh?
What are you saying?
I don't know.
You need an umbrella.
No idea.
It was like a ride at the Ecker.
Thank
the
you.
The cyclone.
But around the rest of the country, we are seeing heatwave conditions in the top end, also showers easing in the coastal central part of Queensland and to the north today. Let's take a look at our Wednesday forecast in our major centres for you right now. Cairns, you're in for a top of 33 degrees. Brisbane, a shower or two, clearing 26 on the way. Looking partly cloudy for Sydney, for Canberra, for Melbourne, for Hobart and for Adelaide today. Perth, cloud clearing, a top of 27 degrees on the way. We are in for a high of 33 for Alice Springs and Darwin. Sunshine today and a top of 37. Well, the timing of this flood event, it really is tedious. Residents have been watching and waiting for days as the Lachlan River starts to peak after all of that heavy drenching rain that we saw last week and also into the weekend. But conditions today are looking fine and lovely here. Unfortunately, though, there are more showers looming on the forecast later this week. So we'll keep an eye on that and, of course, what this water is doing, guys.
Once again, floods under a clear blue sky. Timmy, thank you. Let's stay in Forbes, where it's been an anxious night for residents as slow-moving floodwaters continue to rise. We're joined now by Forbes Shire Council Mayor Phyllis Miller. Mayor, good morning to you. Thank you for your time this morning. How are you all holding up?
We're good, Carl. We've been waiting for this flood for about almost a week now. It's a snail pace moving flood. Fortunately, state water has reduced the outflows out of Boyangla, and of course we've got lots of vegetation around at the moment, so it's just a wait and see game.
Oh, it's been the big slow, hasn't it? Awful.
It is awful, and people start to get complacent because our lake system in town is still beautiful. You can walk around the lake There's no signs of flooding. And, of course, that makes people think that we're crying wolf. But our river is coming up and it will peak sometime today. Mm. And every flood's different and we're not sure what that will do inside the town or what will happen with the lake system when that water starts to join up with the river water.
Just looking at our drone shots now this morning and you can see it, those flood waters and the flood plains there. Obviously, it goes earlier in some parts other than other parts. Is there any indication further upstream at all at this point of how high that river will go, or is it still undetermined?
Where they've predicted, the BOM has predicted a height of 10.65, and that, of course, is the similar height to what we had in 2016. And, of course, that causes some major flooding right throughout. But the sad thing for us, Carl, is our farmers.
I know.
They had bumper crops. They were very excited about the season. And, of course, acres and acres of them are being washed away, and that's millions and millions of dollars to the Australian economy. So my heart goes out to all of our farming community.
I know, and then you've got the clean-up. I mean, this is the problem here, is that it could take days. You've got more rain coming, so that could turn into weeks. Are you worried about the rain later in the week, on the weekend?
Yes, I am, Carl. I'm always an optimistic yeah. about things like this, but this has a real smell of 2012 flood. We had a flood like this, and then, of course, it started to recede, and then we got enormous rains. And, of course, when that happens, Wangla is sitting over 100%. They will have no choice but to put water down our river. So I think we're not out of the woods yet, and I think we've got to get through the spring and summer rains, and hopefully we do come out the other end.
Heading for a wet summer. In terms of the preparation, at least it's given you time, given how slowly it's gone up, but when you add more water to the already overflowing system, that's got to be a big concern for you, and that complacency creeping into to life in town as well.
That's my real concern, is the complacency. And I've been doing some really strong messaging on that, hoping that people do listen. We've had the evacuation warnings, and of course we haven't got the best system in the world, Carl. So some of those evacuations are people that live on top of a hill. So you can imagine the scepticism that we're trying to fight. But that is the system we've got. They are volunteers. They're people that are coming into our community that don't know the lay of the land here. So we're sort of battling against that as well. So hopefully we get a better system between now and our next flood.
I saw that last night on the news. It gave me a wry smile. Some of the SES, younger SES people trying to tell some of the old dogs in town to get out. Anyway, it's all part of the rich tapestry of a flood. We wish you all the very best. Thank you for your time today, and we'll talk to you in the next couple of days. Thank you, Mayor. Good to talk to you. Lovely Forbes. Ali.
Don't mess with those old dogs, do you? They know what they're talking about.